everybody, I'm Kirsty Meeking. Welcome back to the Naio Nails channel. I'm going to show you how to make your very own tie-dye transfer. Oh my god. And we're going to use gel polish. So, what you will need is sort of three or four colours. I've chosen these colours, which, what was that one called, JJ? JJ? I'm calling you JJ, it's not JJ, it's just J.
I used to get called JJ, actually. First Night it's called.
First Night. And then we've got Carambola and Chartreuse and Azori. So, you know, tie-dye can be like any colour, can't it? So you can really play around with that. You will need some backing paper from a sculpting form, like so. And what we're going to do is going to create this tie-dye by just painting random. That's a bit thick. Make sure you don't go too thick. Random splodges of colour. And kind of go swoosh through here. And we're going to swoosh. Don't worry about emerging, but do make sure that you wipe your brush before you put it back in the bottle. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to fold this over. Fold it over. Give it a bit of a squish. Snap it back. Peel it back. Look at that. Oh my god. Look at that. We have a tie-dye effect. Can you see how the colours kind of run into each other? Just like a tie-dye does.
That one looks like a frog.
It does look like a frog, doesn't it? I'm just going to pop those bubbles. Any bubbles that you've got, just get a brush and just pop them. So it's that quick action of pressing and pulling back quickly that gives you those lovely lines. So now we're going to pop this in to the lamp. While that's in the lamp, we're going to take our nail and I'm going to use Cashmere as the background colour. This is one of those designs that can be done very quickly in the salon but will look like wow. They look like there's been hours of effort. So I'm going to do two coats of that colour. I'm going to wipe over with gel residue wipe off solution just to take off a sticky layer. At this point, you're going to choose the best part of your tie-dye, your favourite bit. Now, I want to do like a chevron smile line, hence the reason that I did this, like a nude colour. I want it to look like it's a, you know, a natural nail as such. And we're going to pick the best bit, I think. Because you think how big the nail is and what will be seen once you've cut it. So you want to sort of cut through your favourite bit, and I'm going to cut through this part here. So what you can do is just cut a section out, and then that you could put between some foil, or you could put it in between greaseproof paper, or even put it, fold it up and put it into a little bag. Save that for when you have other clients that want a little bit of tie-dye, and you can pull it out, whack it on, so easy, just like a transfer. So easy. So I've got my little piece that I've cut out, and then I'm going to figure out which bit I'm going to cut. So obviously you want to guess a little bit with a person's finger. I'm not going to go too close because the nail is curved. But I want a guide. So you need to go slightly bigger than you need. Yeah, so you could do a full nail if you wanted to. I'm going to do this chevron kind of smile line. So I'm going to cut this into there. Right, so now I'm going to peel this off. You can slide it up here. It is a bit sticky. So you can see how this is still sticky underneath. Because it's sticky, it's going to stick nicely to the nail. So you get to position that where you want to. You can clean up any of the wet gel that may be underneath. Do that before you go in the lamp. Going to take a piece of plastic, and that's going to hold the nail. Well, it's going to hold the transfer into place. So if you struggle with actually painting a normal smile line, you know, your normal curved smile line, this could be a way, because you might be able to cut it into a gel sort of transfer like we've done here. You might be able to do that a little bit easier. The plastic's just going to hold it flat a little bit. Right, I'm going to hold that down while it goes in the lamp. Because believe it or not, even though, you know, you're thinking, well, it's cured, it's not going to do anything, it will actually cure a little bit more in the lamp because of the underside being quite sticky. What I'm going to do now is cut off any excess. Top coat with matte, make sure you catch the edges, that's really important. What we're going to do is we're just going to neaten those sides where your little transfer wraps around the nail. I'll neaten it up, but it'll also break the seal, so we do have to seal again. But there is something else that I want to do before we seal. So to really make this pop, we're going to add a little bit of black. So this is serious black. Just need to use this as an art medium basically. You could use acrylic paint if you haven't got the black. I'm sure everybody's got serious black. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go from here and pull my line with striping brush to the top. Now let's start here. So we're going to start from the middle and come down. Make sure the whole length of the brush has gel polish on. And I'm going to pull straight down. Pop that in the lamp. Right, I'm going to put some stones on and I'm going to use the aqua gel for that, as I use all the time. Absolutely love it. So I'm just going to place a little bit of aqua gel where I'm going to put the stones. I'm just going to smooth that a little bit by just flattening it a little bit. I'm going over that with matte top coat. So this is really important to seal those edges. If you don't seal those edges, your little transfer that we've made out of gel polish will peel. Make sure you seal those edges. Even if you're doing it with the Urban Graffiti top coat, which is the shiny one, make sure you seal those edges.
Yeah, beautiful that is.
Beautiful tie-dye nail. Obviously with a little bit of bling, because I couldn't quite resist the bling. And I think it needed that little bit of black. You could do white as well, just to give it a bit of a frame, make it like quite cool, very geometric. It's a vibe, for sure. There you are. If you've enjoyed this video, don't forget to check us out on Instagram and Facebook and all that shebang. Everything I've used today will be in the description box below, so if you're interested in finding out how to get your hands on them, there it is. I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.